a lot of our kiddos, when we're talking about things like posture, we want to make sure that we're really aware of what postures are going to be supportive and inhibiting of creating some of this or developing these fine motor skills. A lot of children assume this kind of W sitting posture. There's a lot of reasons why both occupational therapists, physical therapists, and maybe some other clinicians are really going to encourage you to facilitate other postures and positions for your child. W sitting puts a lot of undue stress on some joints. It gives us a really unnatural posture in a lot of different ways. Kiddos tend to assume this W sitting posture because with their legs being outspread, like you see here, it gives her a wider base of support. But what it does is it eliminates those subtle postural muscles that we require when we're sitting or we're doing other movement activities to engage. So a W sitting posture for a lot of different reasons is something that we try to avoid as best we can. Ultimately, our goal, if we're sitting on the floor, is to achieve a posture similar to this. If we're doing this crisscross position or this tailor sitting position, this is going to be much better posturally for your child. But very often, if your child is doing this W position, switching to a crisscross position is very challenging. It puts a lot of, it's a big stretch for their child, your child, because ultimately what it's doing is they're used to having their hips turn inward and rest their bodies down. The crisscross position requires your hips to turn outward and your body to sit up. It can be challenging. So we know that this isn't something that we can automatically go to all the time, which is why we might look for alternative postures. Things like a ring sitting position. So you can see this little one's feet are touching, the bottoms of their feet are touching, and they're not crossed over as much here. That'll eliminate some of that stretch on the hips and encourage your child to sit a little bit more functionally this way. Some other things to consider too, if crisscross position is too tricky or something that you want to try something else, side sitting is a great alternative. Long sitting, you can see right here. So this little one is long sitting where his feet are out in front of him. That creates a lap for his book. And then he has some support, but with the fence that's behind him. So some options there. If we are ultimately having your child sitting on the floor for a lot of activities, and sometimes that's what we need to do because that's just where we're going to get our work done. But maybe W sitting or some of these other postures are challenging or can be challenging. You might consider a lap desk like this little one is using. Ultimately, we would love for children to sit in this really beautiful posture where they're sitting at this 90-90-90 position where their hips are positioned at 90 degrees, knees are positioned at 90 degrees, and our feet are firmly planted on the floor and our ankles are at 90 degrees. This is a great posture and position if we're sitting at the table, but very often that's not always possible. Some additional things to consider when we're looking at this is some ways in which we can support them as best as possible. So maybe we need to put a cushion under their bottom or sit them upright. If they're sitting at the dining room table, maybe putting a box or a stool or a chair underneath their feet so their feet don't dangle. We have a lot more additional kind of postural suggestions in some of our other webinars. So I highly recommend going to check them out if you haven't already.